every time. It's scary. Every single time. Talk about a first world problem, complaining about how scary it is to open up champagne. You know what I mean? Oh, God. Worth it. Boop, boop. Wax paper, you do so much for me. I drink water every day.
Okay, guys, long story short, I'm a baking god.
Hey guys, this week at My Drunk Kitchen, yeah, I know, I don't have a champagne flute. I'm not there yet. Baby steps, come on, guys. This week on a very special My Drunk Kitchen, we are going to be making a delicious cheddar bay biscuit. That's a biscuit that's got like Italian herbs and is savory, but it's fluffy and also cheddary, and it's pretty great. I'm salivating so much, I was worried I was gonna choke on my own spit. But that's not the only, hello? Wait a minute. What does it mean? Nothing. Anyway, I've actually tried to make this recipe twice before, and the first time it turned out like this. Huh. Biscuit while you're ahead? And the second time it turned out like this. It's smaller but the same. Tasty though. And now it's the third time I'm going to try and create this cheddar. And third time's a charm, so I'm gonna try and recreate this cheddar bay biscuit just one more time because I can't do it yet. Why is it not working?
I haven't the foggiest.
So in addition to having followed the recipe online, I've also looked up Google, why are my biscuits so flat? And one of the tips I was given was to cut up and chill my butter ahead of time. Cubed butter and chill, get it? And thus with this chilled cold butter, I'm gonna start baking. Step number five, preheat the oven to 450 because we are aiming for success these days and we're also step number two is to put flour, salt, baking powder, and garlic powder into a food processor. But I don't have that. So instead, bam, 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 nailed it in one. Okay, turns out I can just use a fork. So I'm mixing this all together. It's very mixing. It's very nice. It smells, oh my God, why am I burping so much? And pour flouts, flout, plop, plop. Now we add the butter. And we're done. And we're done. Mix it all together till the mixture vaguely resembles coarse crumbs. All right, let's do it this way. Bam. That's not gonna work. Guys, when in doubt, finger it out. Here we go, moving it around till it vaguely resembles coarse crumbs. It's a very musical kitchen today.
Does this look like coarse crumbs to you? Is this coarse crumbs? Right, this seems like, uh-oh.
Baking takes so long. Pour flour mixture into a large bowl. Spoiler alert, it's already in a large bowl. Okay. Guys, it's important to know that if you have messy baking fingers, that's part of baking, man. You're baking now, so good job. 1 cup milk, 1 cup milk.
Really good stuff, everybody, really good stuff.
Okay, now because I'm a very cheese-friendly person, I don't have that much shredded cheddar cheese left. Also, just as a note, guys, when you can, buy just a block of cheese, you know? You should buy a block of cheese and shred it yourself. Not should, I'm not telling you should do. Listen, I'm not here to tell you how to live your life. Adding cheese now. Does this seem like enough cheese to you? No, of course not. Then, more cheese. Sure, I'm using a Mexican blend, but hey, guess what? We're all here together, guys. I'm gonna use this egg beater. No, I'm not. Yay, it's doing the thing it said it would do. Guys, look how great all this cheese is getting along together. You know, I feel like we have a lot that we could be learning right now. It's time. How easy was this? Guys, look, we already have our biscuit batter. Slam! Next sippy sip. Next step is to put things on something. You're amazing. Next, we're gonna take up my personal favorite kitchen object, wax paper, and place it on the baking sheet.
We're so close, we're almost done.
So this recipe right here, all of this batter, can you guys see that? Yum, that looks delicious. So let's drop 12 little friends onto here. 1, 2, okay. Bam, 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 yeah. Drop biscuits, what you dropping? Biscuits. Drop biscuits. Biscuits get better. Biscuit, biscuit while you're ahead. Don't be a dis-biscuiter. Uh-oh, I missed the entire thing. Okay, guys, here here we go. I didn't fit 12 on here. Can you see? I didn't exactly. Hold on.
Mamacita.
Okay, as you can see, I didn't exactly get 12 on here. But you know what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. This took a turn. So anyway, it turns out I got 12 on here. Let's put it in the oven for 15 minutes and see what happens this time. Third time's a charm. Let's go, let's go. And we'll transition using this. Skippy! So our biscuits are almost done. Champagne is done. Why? Impermanence. The next thing I have to do is take some melted butter and minced garlic, which I don't have, so I guess I'll have to mince this. Woo! Guys, as I mince this garlic, I actually think it's a perfect time to explain in further detail why I'm making this recipe. I don't know if you've noticed, I'm sure the most astute of you have, that I'm wearing a salmon-colored shirt. Although I don't know if it looks like salmon to you, that's the color it is to me. Everything is up to interpretation. I'm talking about my shirt because you're sure to love the next episode of I Heart Food Mondays. No, this is a bad transition. Anyway, ignore everything I just said. I'm making these Cheddar Bay biscuits because they're really, really, really great to serve with lobster. And if you're thinking, Hannah, lobster, what the f*** are you talking about? Then learn all about that beautiful, it's not beautiful, bug of the ocean. Learn all about lobsters and their ways on this week's episode of I Heart Food tonight at 10 p.m. on the Food Network. Please, 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 it's our third episode. We only have 6, so make sure you watch it, guys. Set your reminder right now, please. Computer, phone, calendar, whatever, but 10, 9 central, Food Network, I Heart Food, episode 3. I'll see you guys tonight. I'll be live tweeting the show on my account, Harto, using the hashtag I Heart Food to talk all about the behind the scenes squeams and dreams of filming this television show. It's really fun. Tweet me your questions too using iHeartFood. That would be great. Okay. Oh, that's garlic. I gotta get back to work. I'll see you guys tonight, 10, 9 central, only on the Food Network. Oh, this is still empty. What am I supposed to do? Cheers. Okay, let's see how it is. Here we go. Steam! I'm okay, and so are these. These turned out kind of fluffier, you guys. They're not done yet. I gotta put the melted butter and the Italian herbs and I gotta mince it, but they're very close. I have some room temperature butter right here in my hand. So I'm gonna put this in the microwave. If you're wondering why I have it directly in my hand right now, you know what? So I'm wondering the same thing. Oops, I found some rosé. Rose, hey girl, hey. Okay guys, so here I have my, here I have my melted butter. I minced the garlic enough. I'm adding some of the garlic, plus a couple of, I'm just gonna crush it with my hands. I'm also adding Italian herbs. Now, take your beautiful biscuit babies. Can you guys see them? They're good. I think the extra cheese really helped. Take this brush guy, put it in the butter sauce, get some of them Italian herbs, maybe some of that minced garlic, yeah. Spread it on the top, oh yeah. And then, bon appetit, baby. Oh my God, that is so,
long story short, I'm a baking god.
I just ate that and it's so good. Oh, parchment paper never hurt anybody. And so what's the moral? The moral is this. Yum, 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 yum. That's it. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being here. I hope that you have enjoyed this video and I will see you later tonight. Tonight, Mondays, 10, 9 central, Food Network. Be there or be square. Guys, there's only 6 episodes, so you know, watch episode 3 because at the end of the day, maybe you like it. Anyway,
it's very dangerous
to know
how to enjoy
this video, turn
your
notifications on if you want to know what I
do
from
here.
Let me know in the comments below. Mwah. Have a great day. Seriously, they're good.